Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today's topic is genomic library. A genome is full of set of the genes of individual. A genomic library is a collection of the bacterial or bacteriophage clones, each clone containing a particular segment of the DNA from the source. For making a genomic library, an organism's DNA is simply sliced up into the pieces, and pieces are put up into the vectors, plasmids or viruses that are taken up by the host bacteria. The entire collection of bacteria or bacteriophages clones that results contain all the genes of that organism. Particular probe can be used to search a genetic library for the certain gene. A probe is a single stranded nucleotide sequence that will hybridize pair into a certain piece of the DNA. Location of the probe is possibly because the probe is either radioactive or the fluorescent. Bacterial cells, each carrying a particular DNA fragment, can be plated onto the agar in a petri dish. After the probe hybridizes in the gene of the interest, the genes can be isolated from the fragment. Now this particular fragment can be cloned further or even analyzed for its particular DNA sequence. The polymerase chain reaction. Carey B. Mullis developed the polymerase chain reaction, PCR, in 1983. Earlier methods of obtaining the multiple copies of the specific sequence of DNA were time-consuming and expensive. In contrast, PCR can create a millions of copies of single gene of any specific piece of the DNA quickly in a test tube. PCR is very specific. The target DNA sequence can be less than one part in a million of the total DNA sample, and this means that single gene or smaller piece of the DNA among all the human genes can be amplified, copied using the PCR. PCR takes its name from the DNA polymerase, the enzyme that carries out the DNA replication in a cell. It is considered as a chain reaction because DNA polymerase will carry out the replication over and over again until there are millions of copies of the desired DNA. PCR does not replace the gene cloning, which is still used whenever a large quantity of the gene or protein product is needed. Before carrying out the PCR primers, sequence of about 20 bases that are the combination complementary to the base of on either side of the target DNA must be available. The primers are needed because DNA polymerase does not start the replication process. It only continue or extend the process after the primer binds by the complementary bases. Pairing to the DNA strand, DNA polymerase copies the target DNA. DNA polymerase is a temperature insensitive, thermostable extracted from the bacterium Thermus aquaticus, which lives in a hot spring. Commonly, this enzyme is known as TAC polymerase. It can withstand high temperature, which is used to separate the double-stranded DNA. Therefore, the replication needs not to be interrupted by the needs to add more enzymes. PCR is done these days in an automatic PCR machine or the thermocycler, which is a routine piece of the equipment in any laboratory. Thanks for watching.